finding a minimum sample size. This is pretty similar to what we did at the end of section 6.1. Given a C confidence level and a margin of error E, this is fixed, remember? The minimum sample size N needed to estimate the population proportion is given by this formula. Again, don't be scared by this formula. This is just solving for N in the formula for margin of error. Again, if N is not a whole number, then round N up to the next whole number. This is pretty similar to the comment that we did at this point when we were in section 6.1. This formula assumes that you have an estimate of P hat and Q hat, because to estimate the sample size, you need P hat and Q hat. But to get these estimates, you need N. This is like a circular relationship between N and these two estimates. If you don't have a previous estimate from a past study, then use P and Q equal 1/2. For these two values, we get the highest value for N. Okay, that will be the minimum sample size required. Example, determining the minimum sample size. You are running a political campaign and wish to estimate with 95% confidence the proportion of registered voters who will vote for your candidate. Your estimate must be accurate within 3% of the two population proportion. Find the minimum sample size needed when no preliminary estimate is available. So, because you do not have a preliminary estimate, use P hat 1/2 and Q hat 1/2. For the 95% confidence level, the critical point is 1.96. We should be familiar at this point with this value. And the margin of error that we want is 3%. So we're replacing the formula for N, 1/2, 1/2, 1.96 divided by 0.03 square. We get this value, 1067.11. So then we round to 1068 voters. So we need at least this number of voters in order to have a margin of error, 3%. Similar problem, but now a preliminary estimate gives 31%. We use a preliminary estimate, 31%. If P hat is 31%, then Q hat is going to be 69%. And then we use those values in the formula. Again, the margin of error is 3%, and the critical value for 95% level of confidence is 1.96. We replace those values and we get 913.2, we round up to 914. So if we use P hat and Q hat equal 1/2, then we will always get a greater minimum sample size. In this case, we get 914. So you need a larger sample size if no preliminary estimate is available.